has a lot of achievement. Let me bring few of here. I will start with Harshal sir's highest education. He has MSc IT IMS from Gujarat University, Ahmedabad. And since 2017, he is with SSIP Incubation Center, Sri ML Gandhi Higher Education Society, Modasa, Sabarkantha as associate expert. And his key roles there are acting as an associate expert on mentor board of SSIP Center to organize and arrange workshop for students of Sri ML Gandhi Higher Education Society to bring awareness about startup and entrepreneurship through conducting various programs in campus by inviting various mentors to conduct meeting with startup of the district and the industry expert to organize, arrange entrepreneurship development program for educating students for startup and framing their business module to bridge the gap between education and industry. He is also a project intern from 2019 at PRL Ahmedabad. He has served as IT trainer at Nidan Technology Private Limited. Sir has conducted training, seminars, workshop, webinar on entrepreneurship development at various prestigious institutes. Some of them are Nirma University, LD College of Engineering, St. Xavier's College of Ahmedabad, Gujarat BBA College, Gujarat Arts and Science College, Ahmedabad, MG Science Institute, Ahmedabad, BK School of Business Management, Gujarat University, Indira Gandhi Open University. Out of many achievements, sir has also received Shri Bharat N. Bhatt Memorial Prize for Commendable Social Service by St. Xavier's College, Ahmedabad, received first position for International Youth Symposium, Gujarat University, for the research paper on automatic rationing system, received first position for innovation fair at Vikram Sarabhai Community Science Center for presenting an idea on automatic rationing system, received first position for competition on physics experiment at CPEX 2017, Indian Association of Physics Teachers, IAPTRC7, presented an innovative experiment in physics. Sir is also founder of Essence Tech, co-founder of ARSOBI, member of Indian Society for Training and Development. Sir, thank you for accepting our invitation. We welcome you for the day one of our international webinar on converting pandemic situation into rewards using technology. Before I hand over the session to Harshal sir, I request all the participants, if you have any questions during session, you can type it in the chat section. Question answer session will be at the end. Feedback link will be given in the chat section after the concluding remarks. And for receiving the certificates, you will have to fill the feedback form. And the feedback form will close in 30 minutes after the session. Now I hand over the session to Harshal sir. Over to Harshal sir for your topic, careers in cloud computing and IoT.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for your brief introduction. And thank you so much, Principal ma'am, for giving me this opportunity to interact with the young minds today and to spend some of my time interacting with this youth. So is the screen visible? I hope it is.
Yes, visible. Sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Just a second, I'll just adjust it. So very good evening and welcome to all the students. Not good evening to everyone, as it is an international webinar. Some of them might be awake in the morning and attending this webinar. So as per your situation, we welcome you all to this international webinar on converting pandemic situation into rewards using technology. First of all, I would like to thank Principal Ma'am Tadi Sharma Vishwavidyalaya for inviting me as a speaker and to introduce this new topic, careers in cloud computing and Internet of Things. So let this session be somewhat informal. So what we can do is, like, when we start the presentation, anyone has queries and doubts, they can type in the chat box and we'll take all those queries and questions as the session begins. So let me begin with the very first thing, that cloud computing, is it a new vision or something, it is old and we don't know. So let me clear this out, that cloud computing is a very old technique which was introduced in 1993, and we now came to know about the cloud computing and the utility of cloud computing during this pandemic. So a very simple example, if I talk about WhatsApp or Facebook or else maybe any of the social media applications. So what happens is, like, everyone wants to upload their own photo on social media or else on something, on some of these social media handles. So what happens is you upload a video and you see that your video has been uploaded lifetime, right? So is this, where is it uploaded? Exactly what is the technology behind that? That is what the exact era of cloud computing when it started, when the Facebook was first introduced. So this is a very, interesting topic, cloud computing. And you believe or don't believe, every second of life you are connected with this word cloud computing. How we will see in the next slides, but believe me, you are connected with this thing. If you just think about your cell phone is constantly connected with the cloud, either Google Cloud or if you are using Apple, then iCloud, right? So how the technology is working and what are the converting this pandemic situation into rewards? This was a title given in the webinar. So how using this technology you can have your own vision of creating your own startup, or else going and plunging into this field in the field of IT. And it is not something in IT, it is a general thing. For example, a student in a commerce can also opt for cloud computing. A student studying in arts can also go for the cloud computing. It's just about clearing your own vision that what cloud computing exactly means, right? So what exactly is cloud? You must be using these applications on a daily basis, such as Facebook that we discussed, WhatsApp, or else Instagram. So what happens is, whenever you upload a photo, or else whenever you upload a status on Facebook, so where that data is been stored, that is stored actually in the cloud server of this company. So how these companies are earning? So Facebook is free of cost, WhatsApp you are using free of cost, Instagram, of course, free of cost. So don't you think that this be... are these people doing social service? No, they don't, because they have their own private space. They have their own private cloud, right? Many of you might be introduced to these technologies previously, but most of the people do not have an in-depth knowledge of how these things work. So if you have an Android phone, you have a Dropbox. If you have Android, you have Google Drive. If you have iPhone, you have iCloud, or else any of the services which you are using. So what happens is, when you listen a song on JioSaavn or else, on Gaana.com, what happens is it plays a song from a cloud. So what exactly is cloud? It is a box. If you can just consider an example of a box in which you have stored n number of things, and whenever you need to pick out any of the thing and you start using it, right? So this is how cloud works. Cloud is basically a virtual platform wherein you can store the thing. So ye sari cheez store kahan hoti hai? Is it in the air? क्या ये चीज हवा में होती है? इट इज नॉट लाइक दैट. इट इज बेसिकली अ टेक्नोलॉजी फ्रॉम द सर्वर रूम टू बी कनेक्टेड टू द रिसोर्स पार्टनर, राइट? सो व्हाट डस दिस मींस इज, देयर इज अ लोकेशन वेयर योर डेटा इज स्टोर्ड एंड यू आर एबल टू यूज डेटा थ्रू द टेक्नोलॉजी विच इज नोन एज क्लाउड. सो यू मस्ट हैव हर्ड अबाउट गूगल क्लाउड सर्वर रूम दैट इज अंडर द ओशन, और इज एनी ऑफ द बिगेस्ट कंपनीज लाइक अमेजॉन वेब सर्विसेज, और इज माइक्रोसॉफ्ट इज वेल. Those server rooms are kept so cool that what happens every time is, you every time click on Facebook or else every time tap on WhatsApp, a microsecond of data is utilized from your server storage, right? So what happens is, you have your own account over there, not in a Swiss bank, in the server room, right? So what you do is, you log in into that account, you use that services for some point of time, and then you log out from the account. Logout is the biggest challenge that we don't do. We do not log out from the Facebook. We do not log out from the WhatsApp or else from the Instagram. It keeps you logged in and you receive notifications daily. So what happens is, your hard disk or the server storage space over there gets filled up, and day by day it gets utilized, and day by day it becomes, the temperature rises. And due to this, they are kept in the ocean. So what happens is, that is your server room. And the things or the applications which you are using on your cell phone. So how those two things are connected, the reason behind that is this whole big cloud technology. So whenever you listen or tap a song on JioSaavn or else Gaana, what happens is, the storage space which is occupied in the server room of JioSaavn, or else if they have taken services from any of the service providers, so a song plays from there and you are able to listen on your cell phone. So this is how the cloud services work. So in depth we'll see afterwards, but thinking on why careers in cloud computing is a very good option. As of nowadays, because what happens is, if you see a GIF in the left, the boy, what he is doing, he is working for some time, then he is going with a gym or else he is exercising, and then and he is going with this puppy on a ride, right? So in the era of 21st century, no one has a time to, utilize all those things in just doing their own work. Everyone wants some time to either do something else or else, to spare time for doing some extra things. So how that happens, how to make life easier for mankind, that is the reason why careers in cloud computing are the most important thing. So what happens is, whenever you build your own cloud, we can say it as a private cloud. So what you can do is, you can store your applications over there, and whenever needed or wherever needed, you can explore those applications, right? So excuse me. So what happens is, if, for example, if you are at the corner of any place, or else if you are in the corner of any of the the whole world, if you want to utilize your own services, like for example, if you have developed some application, or else if you have developed some code or something from which, if you want to execute, so what happens is, you may not have your laptop every time, or else you may not have your hard disk at the same point of time. So what you will do is, you will just log in to any of the computer through your cloud, and you can utilize those services at any place of the world, right? So this is the benefit of cloud computing, and the career, why it is important, because day by day in the era of 21st century, the data is increasing. For example, अगर हमारा फोन चोरी हो जाता है तो वी डोंट हैव एनी फियर बिकॉज इट इज लॉ, बट हमारा डेटा चोरी हो गया, सो इट इज द बिगेस्ट चैलेंज व्हाट यंगस्टर्स फेस दिस केस, नॉट यंगस्टर्स बट एनी इंडिविजुअल फेस दिस केस, बिकॉज एवरी टाइम, एवरी पॉइंट ऑफ सेकेंड, 256 बिलियन ऑफ डेटा इज बीइंग जनरेटेड, 256 बिलियन. सो हाउ यू आर गोइंग टू स्टोर? योर लैपटॉप कंसिस्ट ऑफ नॉट मोर देन 1 TB ऑफ हार्ड डिस्क स्पेस. Your if you have external hard disk, you might be having 2 GB, or else maybe 3 TB, sorry, 3 TB of hard disk space. So if 256 billion of data is increasing in just 1 minute in the whole world, imagine the amount of data to be stored in this server rooms. So what happens is, everyone is running behind this technology called cloud computing. And if you see the GIF in the right, what happens is, this all these people, what they are doing, they are integrating cloud services with the client user interface. So what do you mean by client user interface? Means something which you are using on a cell phone. For example, if you are using a Dropbox, so how does Dropbox work? So there is a configuration which is already been done before the cloud technology. So it fetches your data from the data center, and it shows you data from there. If you download it, or else if you delete it, the same thing will affect on your data center, server or storage space. So server and storage space, both are the two important, both are the two important things which needs to be understand. Server is something on which you deploy your cloud, and storage space is something, it is a kind of a server. You can call it as storage area network, basically. So what happens is, in storage area network, this all configurations are done through which you receive your data at any point of time, right? So this is how the cloud computing, and there is a whole lot of opportunity. If you think about during this pandemic situation, as Principal Ma'am told correctly, that we started to use Zoom, we started to use Microsoft Teams, as well as Cisco Webex, which was not used before. But why people are accepting this case? Because people know the advantages of these technologies, and all these technologies are a part of cloud computing. Believe me, the Zoom what we are using currently is a part of cloud computing. Somewhere or the other, cloud is connected with Zoom. So if you have if you have seen the link of what ma'am has shared to you for joining this meeting, it is written that https://. Then US.02, right? So what is that? That is something, a server of Zoom is in the US, and you are utilizing the services of Zoom through an application. So that is simple. The example of cloud computing, the best example, what we are using right now. If you see about the another company, AWS, so this is Amazon Web Services. Amazon all must be knowing. Amazon Web Services is something which provides a private cloud service to the clients. So what happens is, like, for example, if you want to build your own server room, right? if you want to build your own company, let's say of a server or else for or for the cloud computing or else for the cloud, right? So what happens is you don't have enough finances. So if you want to, you know, create a small storage area network, you need more than, you know, 1 crore rupees to install those server areas, server spaces, server regions, and then you need to have the permissions, right? So what happens is this is a very huge cost. So what these companies do is they have their own server room, they have their own server space, and they what they do is they give this server space on rent to their clients. So what happens is if I want to, if my the name of my company is Essentec, right? So if I want to store my files of the important documents of my company on cloud, so what I will do is I will purchase service space from Amazon Web Services, and then I will store my data over there. Same thing happens with IBM Cloud, Google Azure, VMware, or DigitalOcean, whichever cloud you use. Everything, the concept is the same. The configurations are a little bit different because the companies are different, obviously, right? So what happens is, what these companies are doing, not in the pandemic, they are doing since a long time. The first cloud was introduced by IBM and then by different companies. So what these people have is they have their own server room. They have their own server spaces, right? So they just give on a lease, or else if you can say, they give you on a rental space. So a best example, if we talk about, during this pandemic, everyone would be watching movies or else web series on Amazon Prime, right? So what Amazon Prime is exactly, it is basically a cloud, nothing else. So what happens is you log in through your username and password, or else if you are very smart, you connect it through a VPN, right? And then it logs in into a portal wherein you are able to click on any of the series and you are able to view, right? So why I have told this example, because you would be able to connect it, you know, more practically. So what happens is whenever you click on that movie, there is, some time it will take for loading. So what happens is on the back end, if you see the configuration, it connects to a cloud of Amazon Prime that is on the AWS server, and then it shows you that movie. So that movie is stored in the server space of AWS, and you are able to view on your cell phone without downloading. So this is the technology of cloud. Exactly this is how the cloud works. But there are various sectors in which you can think about your career in the cloud. And if you talk about creating rewards or converting pandemic into the rewards, this is the best opportunity, guys, to, you know, grow up your career in this field, because not many people are, you know, much aware about all these things, on all these, you know, opportunities which you people are getting it today. So it is just simple. Learn these technologies and utilize in your own sector. It is not about IT. It is not about computer science or computer engineering. Cloud is everywhere. If you talk about Farm Easy is an application through which you can order medicines online. So it uses a cloud technology. So cloud technology has careers in robotics, in data science, in artificial intelligence, machine learning, healthcare, army, defense, everywhere this cloud technologies are useful. We'll get on to the applications afterwards, but please try to understand that these technologies work upon, you know, a system where you control everything remotely. For example, if you are sitting over here in Ahmedabad or else in Gandhinagar, and if your data center is in Bangalore or else is in US or else is in Australia, what you need to do is you need to sit over here, configure your whole system, and, you know, give the lease space to your clients. So it is not required that you should be physically present wherever your server is. It is not something like that. Cloud is such a system through which you can control your, you know, the whole system remotely as well. So these are the benefits what cloud gets. So moving on to the next different levels of cloud computing. So there are various levels. It is not just that you become a cloud engineer, or else, for example, if you do some certificate courses that will help you. It's not like that. There are various stages in which you can pursue your career in this field of cloud computing. Let me be very brief with all this thing, because this all, material is available online. This whole thing is available online. You guys must be knowing all this. Just I'll give you an overview of what this job role means and how you can build your career in this job role. So first, if you talk about the solutions architect, the first top role, what cloud computing offers you is something you can, you know, you learn how to control the cloud. For example, a cloud is already developed. For example, you know, a very simple thing, if you have cell phone with your own cell, if you click on Instagram, then you should know that how to upload your image or else how to upload a status, right? Or else how to upload a story, how to add music into that. So this is the role of solution architect. So how to configure in the existing cloud is the job role of solutions architect. आपको क्लाउड बनाने की जरूरत नहीं है, ऑलरेडी क्लाउड डेवलप किया हुआ है, उसको कॉन्फ़िगर कैसे करना चाहिए, उसके ऊपर यू नो डिप्लॉय कैसे होगा, एप्लीकेशन डिप्लॉय कैसे होगा, और एल्स हाउ टू क्रिएट योर ओन स्टोरेज एरिया नेटवर्क, EC2 क्लाउड की बात करो या S3 बकेट की बात करो, तो वो सब आप कैसे कन्फिगर करोगे, दैट इज द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग वट सोल्यूशन आर्किटेक्ट टेक्स केयर अबाउट. द सेकेंड इज क्लाउड डेवलपर. अभी ये डेवलपर शब्द इतना खराब है हमारे एजुकेशन सिस्टम में कि आई एम सॉरी आई एक्सक्यूज माई वर्ड्स बट इफ यू थिंक अबाउट सॉफ्टवेयर डेवलपर जिनका अभी कोई वैल्यू नहीं है मार्केट में, राइट, एवरी वन इज बिहाइंड सॉफ्टवेयर, यू नो सॉफ्टवेयर डेवलप करना है, ये करना है, वो करना है, देर आर लॉट ऑफ इंजीनियर्स विच आर डेवलपिंग सॉफ्टवेयर, बट नाउ इन दी प्रेजेंट सिचुएशन देर इज नो यूज टू बिकम अ सॉफ्टवेयर डेवलपर. Either you become a cloud developer wherein you can build your own software to deploy various clouds, right? So kya job role hota hai cloud developer ka, ki for example there is a software you have built or else anyone else has built, if you want to take it to a platform, for example agar ek user interface hai jisko develop karke, if you want to reach to x number of participants, Google Play Store pe upload kar do ya fir App Store pe upload kar do, that is a different story. बट इफ यू वॉन्ट टू टेक इट इन अ प्रोफेशनल मैनर, और अगर आप ऐसा सोचते हो कि एक ही प्लेटफॉर्म पे एक साथ मेरी कंपनी के 20 इंजीनियर्स काम करने चाहिए, यू नीड टू डेवलप योर ओन क्लाउड, यू नीड टू डेवलप योर ओन प्राइवेट क्लाउड. सो देर इज अ डिफरेंस बिटवीन प्राइवेट एंड पब्लिक क्लाउड, विल सी आफ्टर. सो थर्ड ऑप्शन वॉट यू गेट इज सिसऑप्स एडमिनिस्ट्रेटर. सो वॉट हैपन्स इज यू हैव बीन अ डेवलपर एट सम पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम एंड देन इफ यू वॉन्ट टू एडमिनिस्ट्रेट द होल थिंग. फॉर एग्जाम्पल डेवलप तो आपने पूरा क्लाउड कर लिया, बाद में उसके ऊपर इम्प्लीमेंट कैसे होगा, वॉट आर द स्टेप्स टू इम्प्लीमेंट ऑल दोज टेक्नोलॉजीज, सो दैट इज द जॉब रोल ऑफ सिस ऑप्स एडमिनिस्ट्रेटर. सो दिस आर देर आर सम टूल्स, इफ यू हैव हर्ड अबाउट DevOps, सो DevOps आर बेसिकली टूल्स विच हेल्प यू आउट इन यू नो कोडिंग दिस होल क्लाउड एंड टू यू नो कनेक्ट फ्रॉम द डेटा सेंटर, वॉट वी कॉल जो सर्वर स्टोरेज स्पेस कि जो हम बात कर रहे थे, दैट इज कॉल्ड अ डेटा सेंटर, टू कनेक्ट डेटा सेंटर विद द एंड यूजर, दैट इज कॉल्ड द होल ब्लॉक डायग्राम. इफ यू सी द होल ब्लॉक डायग्राम इज डेवलप बाय DevOps इंजीनियर. सो DevOps इंजीनियर के साथ साथ ये सारे लोग काम करते हैं. दिस इज द बंच ऑफ ग्रुप विच एक्ट्स एज अ क्लाउड कंप्यूटिंग रोल. सो ऐसा नहीं है कि आप सिसऑप्स एडमिनिस्ट्रेटर बन गए या फिर सोल्यूशन आर्किटेक्ट बन गए तो यू वुड बी एबल टू स्टार्ट योर ओन कंपनी ऑफ क्लाउड. You need to have at least 5 of these engineers or else 5 of these people in your company to develop your own cloud. So developing your own cloud or taking services is a different thing. But if you are thinking to build up your career in the, you know, field of cloud computing, it is better to develop your own cloud, either, you know, renting from someone and renting to someone, right? Renting from someone and renting to someone. Like, for example, if you are rented from AWS and if you are renting some websites to x number of participants. अगर आप GoDaddy देखते हो या फिर HostGator देखते हो तो वो लोग क्या करते हैं, आपके पास से पैसे लेते हैं, ठीक है, आपको एक डोमेन देते हैं और आपका वेबसाइट होस्ट भी करवाते हैं. देर इज अ कम्बाइंड पैकेज इफ यू सी. सो वॉट हैपन्स इज दे अर्न फ्रॉम बोथ द वेज, दे गिव यू डोमेन स्पेस, ठीक है, एंड देन दे हेल्प यू इन होस्टिंग एज वेल. सो ये जो होस्टिंग करते हैं, दैट इज द रोल ऑफ क्लाउड कंप्यूटिंग, नॉट द रोल ऑफ सॉफ्टवेयर डेवलपर, राइट. तो होस्टिंग कहाँ पे होता है, आपका एक प्राइवेट क्लाउड होता है या फिर एक पब्लिक क्लाउड पे यू कैन होस्ट. तो दैट जॉब रोल, वो पूरा डिजाइन करना, दैट इज द जॉब रोल ऑफ सिसऑप्स एडमिनिस्ट्रेटर. इफ यू गो टू द फोर्थ लेवल ऑफ एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन, देन कम्स द क्लाउड नेटवर्क इंजीनियर. इफ यू थिंक कि आपको कोडिंग नहीं पसंद है या फिर इफ यू डोंट लव कोडिंग और आप कोडिंग नहीं करना चाहते हो, द बेस्ट ऑप्शन इज टू बिकम अ क्लाउड नेटवर्क इंजीनियर. सो यू हैव टू वर्क विद डिफरेंट टेक्नोलॉजीज लाइक LAN है, WAN है, VPN है, ठीक है. सो दिस आर द टेक्नोलॉजीज विच कम्स इन टू द नेटवर्किंग पार्ट. कि आपका फॉर एग्जाम्पल नेटवर्क कैसे डेवलप होगा. आज मेरी कंपनी में लेट्स से देर आर 500 एम्प्लॉयज एंड आई वॉन्ट टू ऑफर माई क्लाउड सर्विसेज टू ऑल द 500 एम्प्लॉयज. सो हाउ दोज 500 वुड बी 500 एम्प्लॉयज वुड बी कनेक्टेड इन अ सिंगल स्पेस. दैट इज द जॉब रोल ऑफ नेटवर्क इंजीनियर. सो वट नेटवर्क इंजीनियर डज इज इट प्रोवाइड्स अ लीज लाइन टू एवरी वन एंड देन थ्रू दैट लीज लाइन दे आर कनेक्टेड और इनडायरेक्टली कनेक्टेड टू द क्लाउड. सो दिस इज वॉट द जॉब रोल ऑफ नेटवर्क इंजीनियर इज. सो नेटवर्क इंजीनियर डज नॉट डिपेंड ऑन एनी ऑफ द जॉब कंप्यूटिंग और एल्स क्लाउड कंप्यूटिंग रोल्स, राइट. So the fifth and the last is cloud DevOps engineer. If you think that you know everything, you have been as a network engineer as well, SysOps bhi kar liya, develop bhi kar liya khud ka cloud. Now if you want to start your own company, so you have to have certain knowledge of what DevOps tools are and how DevOps engineer works. So the last and the foremost stage of cloud computing is a DevOps engineer. So what he or she does is, it interfaces, like it integrates your data center to the end user. Like for example, end user is your client. In this scenario, for example, if you are the owner of JioSaavn, right, and I am the customer, so I am your end client. And what you do is you take services from Amazon, you give me the services. For example, $399 aap mujhse lete ho for 1 year, right, to have JioSaavn Pro, right. So what that means is you give, I pay you money and you give me cloud service, right? We have disabled it. और जो हम सुनते हैं free वाला, so वहाँ पे उन्होंने ads enable किया हुआ होता है. So ये जो पूरा job role है, वो कौन संभालेगा? The DevOps engineer will take care of all these computing things. So believe me or not, out of 10 skills you have as an IT engineer or as a computing engineer in today's current market, 7.92% skills you require is of cloud computing. If you go to any of the company, they will offer you a certified course on cloud computing. Either they will tell to pursue on your own self or to get knowledge from someone who knows, right? So why cloud computing is important? Because if you see the current pandemic situation, the work from home in IT companies is the biggest challenge. Why? Because you have to connect your server to the remote places. So normally what happens is, agar aapki office mein aapne server rakha hua hai, you connect it through a LAN cable, speed bhi achhi aayegi aur aapka kaam bhi jaldi aur fatafat se hoga. But if you are working from home, then aap thodi utna lamba LAN cable khichoge. It is not, you know, physically possible. If I stay in Vadodara and if my office is at Gandhinagar, so how will I extend the whole cable? Agar aap Wi-Fi se connect karte ho, so you won't be able to log in to your server, because server agar aapko use karna hai, you need some physical connection or else you need a private connection through which you connect it to your own server. So how do that happen? If either you use TeamViewer on your desktop in your, you know, agar aapki company ka desktop hai, if you have your own desktop in your company, if you take a TeamViewer of that, or else aap any desk ya fir koi bhi remote applications use karke kaam karte ho, then it works. But if you want to directly, you know, communicate, if you want your laptop to directly communicate with your server, the best option is you need to have cloud. So every company nowadays is thinking about to hire a people or to hire anyone who has basic knowledge of cloud. So basic knowledge, what does it mean? At least you should be a solutions architect. Aapko pata hona chahiye ki ye cloud ko kaise handle karna chahiye. At the right hand side image, what you see is a salary in INR. This is an average salary. The source I get this from Google, it is not sure that you will get salary only, but kind of average you can consider in India, around this much salary is being paid to a cloud engineer nowadays. But it may happen after, you know, n number of years that this salary would be doubled or else tripled as per the need of the customer. So as a senior software engineer, there are various ratios which you can see on the screen. You should have this much of skill set and knowledge of cloud computing. So opportunity for startups, as I talked about, during this pandemic situation, if you think you want to provide services to the education consultancies or else to the educational institutes, but what happens is every university or every college or every institution, educational institution, if we talk about, does not have that skill set to, you know, physically monitor this thing or else to compute this thing or else to, you know, take care of all this necessary things to be built for teaching online. Teaching online does not mean uploading a video on YouTube or taking a lecture on Zoom classes, right? So what does online teaching means? So if you see the left-hand image, so these are the various things which you need to take care of when you configure the whole network where the online teaching goes on. If you want to have your own private cloud, and if you want to do an online teaching, you should have a mobile through which you integrate, or else a laptop through which you integrate. You should have a database where your data is stored. Either your cloud should be connected to private, public, or hybrid cloud. Hybrid cloud is something, for example, there should be some space of private and some space of public cloud, which combines and forms a hybrid cloud. As per the necessity, the client uses it. You should have a server, of course, where the data is being stored, and you should have a storage capacity and a storage server. So storage server is a different thing, database is a different thing, right? So आपको ये पूरा सिनारियो रेडी करना पड़ता है इफ यू वांट टू बिल्ड एन एप्लीकेशन लाइक जूम टू प्रोवाइड ऑनलाइन सर्विसेज ड्यूरिंग दिस पैंडेमिक. एंड कन्वर्टिंग पैंडेमिक इनटू रिवॉर्ड मींस हैविंग योर ओन स्टार्टअप, और एल्स नॉट हंटिंग फॉर अ जॉब, और एल्स अगर आपको जॉब मिला है तो यू थिंक समथिंग आउट ऑफ द बॉक्स एज प्रिंसिपल मैम टोल्ड करेक्टली. सो व्हाई इज दिस इम्पॉर्टेंट? बिकॉज नाउ डेज देर आर नो जॉब्स करेंटली अवेलेबल इन द मार्केट. And what happens is there is a huge salary hike which goes on due to which people are leaving jobs currently. जिनका जनरल मैनेजर का 75,000 सैलरी था, उनका सैलरी 35,000 है. जिनका 50,000 था, ही आर स्टार्टिंग इन 25,000. जिनका 25 था, उनका तो बात ही मत पूछो, राइट? सो दिस इज अ करंट सिचुएशन विच वी प्रे दैट इट मे नॉट लास्ट लॉन्ग, बट इफ समथिंग कम्स इन द फ्यूचर, इफ सम पैंडमिक कम्स अगेन, यू शुड बी एबल टू सर्वाइव एंड यू शुड बी एबल टू डू समथिंग ऑन योर ओन, राइट? सो टू डू समथिंग ऑन योर ओन, यू शुड हैव द नॉलेज ऑफ क्लाउड कंप्यूटिंग थ्रू विच यू कैन हैव योर ओन स्टार्टअप, और एल्स हैव योर ओन कंपनी विच प्रोवाइड सर्विसेज टू द क्लाइंट्स. आइदर इन हेल्थ सेक्टर, फॉर एग्जाम्पल, आप नॉर्मल एक मेडिकल शॉप ले लो, ठीक है? और अगर आपने ऐसा कुछ क्लाउड डेवलप किया जिसके कारण यू आर फेचिंग डेटा फ्रॉम द कस्टमर्स कि उनको कौन सी मेडिसिन की जरूरत है, विच आर द मेडिसिन दे रिक्वायर ऑन डेली बेसिस, और वो मेडिसिन का एक डेटा बेस क्रिएट किया, देन उसकी कितने शॉप से आपके एरिया के अंदर जो ये मेडिसिन रखते हैं उसका एक लिस्ट आपने बनाया दैट यू हैव स्टोर्ड इन अ स्टोरेज एरिया नेटवर्क, एंड देन यू हैव कनेक्टेड बोथ टू योर सर्वर. तो क्या होगा कि जब भी कस्टमर, जैसे मुझे मेडिसिन परचेज करना है, सो वेन एवर आई लॉग इन टू योर एप्लीकेशन, सो वट आई विल डू इज आई ऑर्डर द मेडिसिन, और वो मेडिसिन ऑर्डर कहाँ से होगा? आपके नियर बाई मेडिकल स्टोर से. तो हाउ टू कनेक्ट अ क्लाइंट, अ मेडिकल स्टोर, यू योर सेल्फ एंड योर डेटा सेंटर, और एल्स योर सर्वर स्टोरेज स्पेस. सो दिस होल टेक्नोलॉजी, द होल द होल सिनेरियो इज कनेक्टेड थ्रू अ क्लाउड. सिंपल एप्लीकेशन मैंने दिखाया, यू कैन अर्न आउट ऑफ दैट. यू कैन चार्ज 2 or 3 rupees एक्स्ट्रा फॉर अ सिंगल मेडिसिन, एंड यू कैन सेल बिलियंस ऑफ मेडिसिन ड्यूरिंग दिस काइंड ऑफ पैंडमिक. एवरी वन इज फियरिंग टू गो आउट फ्रॉम देयर हाउस, वाई नॉट टू डिलीवर एट देयर ओन प्लेस? सो वट हैपन्स इज यू डेवलप योर ओन क्लाउड एंड यू डू समथिंग लाइक दिस इन द हेल्थ केयर सेक्टर, विच वी कॉल्ड इट एज नाउ एज ई हेल्थ केयर, विच विल हेल्प यू आउट इन फ्यूचर ईयर्स टू कोप अप विद दिस pandemic, and if something other happens, you can utilize the same knowledge to grab in something else. I hope I am audible. Hello.
Yes, sir.
You are audible.
Okay, thank you. Just a minute. So basically, this was a basic overview of what is cloud computing. Many more things to, if you want to learn, you have to explore in this PT. Let me not make it a boring lecture. Let me make it a very precise note on what IoT is, because because you use it daily, the IoT, the Internet of Things, in daily life, right? So whenever you go out of your home, whenever you're at your office, you connect the whole devices of your home through this word called Internet of Things. It is something you connect your electrical devices remotely. So connecting electrical devices remotely? Because what happens is, if you just imagine how much electricity you use in your daily life, if you just calculate the cost, you will think that 30 to 40% of the electrical cost is wasted. Why? Because you forget to switch off your AC, you forget to switch off your, the fan or the tube light or any of the electrical appliances which works on. So, in the right hand side, if you see the how many devices were connected through IoT in 1992, that was around 10 billion of devices and 1 million of devices which was connected to IoT in 1992. But as the days passed and as the technology flourished, we were able to use this technology at a real time, due to this internet, the internet help and everything which works on with this technology. So what happens is, if you are at your factory and if you just think that you have switched on your server in the IT cabin, and if you want to switch off from your own factory, you can switch off remotely. You need not to have your own laptop. You need not to have, a physical space where you can log in somewhere and you can, switch it off. Just a tap of your cell phone and you can, control everything. So this is what IoT is all about. Everyone knows about this technology and no more description on why it is important. Everyone knows the importance. But the major thing is 50 billion of devices are connected in 2020. Through the IoT. Why this is important? अगर आप आपकी और मेरी घर की बात करें तो ऐसा भी हो सकता है कि we do not use IoT because घर पे ही रहना है तो IoT की कोई जरूरत नहीं है. But think about a situation where everyone is doing job at their home, घर पे कोई नहीं रहता, and if you forget to switch off your AC or else if you forget to switch off your washing machine, ठीक है, तो क्या होगा? या तो आपका washing machine चालू रहेगा या फिर अपने आप बंद हो जाएगा इफ इट इज स्मार्ट. अभी तो स्मार्ट वॉशिंग मशीन आते हैं, राइट? सो इफ इट इज नॉट स्मार्ट, व्हाट हैपेंस इज वो जो छोटा सा लाइट है वो चालू रहेगा. सो आपको ऐसा लगता है कि इससे कुछ ज्यादा इलेक्ट्रिसिटी कंज्यूम नहीं होता, बट इफ यू थिंक प्रैक्टिकली देर आर एन नंबर ऑफ थिंग्स विच वर्क्स लाइक दिस ओनली. सो टू सेव ऑल दिस इलेक्ट्रिसिटी कॉस्ट एंड टू कंट्रोल, आई यूज द वर्ड कंट्रोल द इलेक्ट्रिकल अप्लायंसेस, IoT इज मच रिक्वायर्ड इन द एरा ऑफ 21st सेंचुरी. So when and where? So this is a very simple thing. Wherever you are and whenever you want to control, you can control your appliances through a single application of your IoT. So many of the startups who are working in healthcare, so what happens is, as ma'am told correctly, you need not to visit doctor during this pandemic. You can, have a Zoom call or else on a Google Meet, and you can tell about your disease and you can tell something, you can interact with the doctor and he would be able to prescribe a medicine. So where IoT in healthcare is useful is something, for example, if you have a blood pressure or if you have diabetes and if you are checking daily through an appliance at your home. Abhi to chota mota appliances aate hai to check your blood pressure at your home. So if that device is connected through IoT and that data goes to a doctor on a daily basis, abhi doctor bhagwan to hai nahi jo ek baar naap ke bata dega ki aapko ye bimari hai, he should have some patterns to study. Usko pata hona chahiye ki aapne last medicine kaun sa liya tha and what is your temperature right now, ya fir kya kya aapko for example what things you are facing right now, क्या क्या बॉडी में प्रॉब्लम्स है. सो ये सारी चीज कैसे होगी? जो भी आप अप्लायंसेस यूज करते हो, वो अप्लायंसेस दे आर डायरेक्टली और इनडायरेक्टली कनेक्टेड. इफ दे आर कनेक्टेड थ्रू IoT, डॉक्टर कैन स्टडी. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, आज 2020 में जनवरी से लेके अभी जुलाई अगस्त तक आपको कितनी बार ब्लड प्रेशर राइज हुआ, डिक्रीज हुआ, या फिर डायबिटीज में इट हैज इंक्रीज और डिक्रीज. इफ दे स्टडी अ पैटर्न, देन दे आर द बेस्ट डॉक्टर्स टू प्रिस्क्राइब द मेडिसिन. ठीक है, सो फार्मासिस्ट का काम क्या होता है? They give the medicine or they prescribe a medicine to a doctor and doctor indirectly prescribes us. So if this whole technology is connected through IoT, a client would be directly interacting with a doctor. No need of medical store, no need of pharmacist or unka kuch prescription wagera nahi chahiye. Just a doctor can log into his or her own device and they can study your, how much diabetes you have or what are the sort of, medical things what you are taking it daily. उसको ये भी पता होना चाहिए कि डायबिटीज के अलावा आप कौन सी दवाइयाँ लेते हो. Because what happens is sometimes if you cannot take two same kind of medicines or you cannot use two same kind of drugs at the same point of time in your body. So if he doesn't know, then he would not be able to help you out, and you would be suffering from another disease. So IoT is the best application in the healthcare sector currently. And if you go on studying, there is a whole lot of advantage in defense as well. जैसे कि हमने आर्मी की बात की थी, डिफेंस सेक्टर में आर्मी कई जगह पे लड़ने जाती है, ठीक है? So how you come to know through radar कि वो कहाँ पर है, वो तो पता चलेगा उनका location, but you don't know कि उनके supplies कितने हैं उनके पास कुछ सामान है या खाली हो गया, they have bullets, they have food appliances, medical equipments है या नहीं है. So IoT से क्या पता चलेगा उनके stocks के बारे में, you will come to know कि for example आज यहाँ पे लड़ाई हुई तो इतना things are being used. एक आर्मी का बंदा होगा who will update it on a daily basis. So a person sitting in a head office would be able to monitor the requirement, और वो उसके हिसाब से he will send all the necessary equipments on the battlefield, right? So a whole lot of application in defense as well. So internet of things is everywhere. If you see in flight services, आपको जो message आ जाता है, that is because of the IoT. अगर आप वहाँ पे enter हो जाते हो, ठीक है, आप airport पे enter हो जाते हो, you will be able to receive a message from XYZ Airlines, जहाँ से आपने टिकट बुक करवाया है, या फिर जो भी एयरलाइंस का आपने टिकट परचेस किया है कि आपका फ्लाइट इतने बजे शेड्यूल पे है, ठीक है? If the gate is changing, you would be able to receive a message. So how is it connected? Through IoT. So कोई भी सेक्टर ले लो, everything is connected with the IoT. Startups की बात करें, so IoT Nest is one of the startup in Ahmedabad which works on the same principle and which works on the same things as well. कि कैसे फॉर एग्जांपल अगर आप घर पे नहीं हो तो आपका मॉड्यूल कैसा होना चाहिए ताकि आप अपना और रिमोटली आप उस चीज़ को कनेक्ट कर पाओ. फॉर एग्जांपल आज आप ऑफिस से कोई चीज़ को कनेक्ट कर रहे हो तो आपके फ्यूज बॉक्स में, घर के फ्यूज बॉक्स में एक मॉड्यूल लगा होगा, एंड दैट मॉड्यूल वुड बी इंटीग्रेटेड थ्रू द एप्लीकेशन व्हाट यू हैव इन योर सेलफोन, राइट? सो इंटीग्रेटिंग दैट एप्लीकेशन इज द जॉब रोल ऑफ IoT Nest. So what this company do is they are connected to a cloud, they are connected to clients and they provide services to the clients. Agar aap dekho, to yahan pe bahut bada shabd hai server. So server is the most important thing. Kahin pe bhi aap duniya mein chale jao, aapko server to chahiye. Kuch bhi control karna hai remotely, you should have the access of server. So what these people do is they purchase server space from XYZ company and they build their own application which they install in new buildings as well as the existing buildings as well. कि जहाँ पे आने के बाद you will come to know that how you can control the whole building through your own cell phone. अगर आपको आपका parking space book करना है, ठीक है? So अभी के जो नए नए buildings develop होते, what happens is you have to pre-book your parking space कि आपकी जगह पे और कोई vehicle ना रखते. तो आप कैसे कर सकते हो? Through the use of IoT Nest module, you can do that thing. Because it is connected with the technology which give the access to your office, to your home, to XYZ or any place which you consider, right? So this is how these people work. So this is just a simple opportunity which you all guys know, but you don't know how to pursue this opportunity. So this, the first step of pursuing this opportunity is to complete your bachelor's degree program along with the certification courses in cloud and IoT. So expanding career opportunity does not mean you leave everything what you are doing and go to the cloud, right? So what happens is many people do is they analyze that this is the biggest opportunity. Abhi chalo na chodo, BTech chhodte, apne kuch cloud ke andar karte. So this is not a solution, right? So what you have to do is you have to complete your bachelor's degree program or उसके बाद यू हैव टू परस्यू योर मास्टर्स आइदर इन क्लाउड और एल्स इन द IoT सेक्टर और मे बी इन द आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस एज वेल इफ़ यू वॉन्ट टू गो ऑन विद दिस काइंड ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजीज. सो वाई आई एम इंसिस्टिंग यू टू परस्यू योर डिग्री, बिकॉज ओनली सर्टिफिकेशन विल नॉट हेल्प यू आउट गेटिंग अ जॉब. लेट मी बी वेरी फ्रैंक, बिकॉज आई नो द करेंट सिचुएशन इन द मार्केट, नॉट द करेंट सिचुएशन, एनी सिचुएशन, यू शुड हैव अ डिग्री इन द स्पेसिफिक एरिया through which you want to get a very good job. If you want to, be a system administrator or else agar aapko kuch analysis karna hai, chota mota job chahiye, okay, certificates are fine, they will help you out getting a job. But if you want to, have a good company, a good job, if you want to develop your own cloud, if you want to work in this emerging fields, you should have a specific degree on cloud computing. So IBM provides cloud computing. There are many companies, if you search in Google, they provide cloud computing. So if you see this image, career and life goals, हम सबके सेम होते हैं, राइट? सो व्हाट एग्जैक्टली इज लाइफ गोल्स? यही होता है कि हमने पढ़ाई कर ली, अभी ऐसे पैसों की बारिश होगी, जो एक्चुअली में नहीं होता है. एवरीवन नोज दैट व्हेन वी स्टेप आउट इन द मार्केट वी हैव टू वर्क रियली हार्ड टू अर्न मनी, राइट? और जिसको नहीं पता उसको समझ जाना चाहिए अभी दैट दिस इज नॉट अ करेंट सिचुएशन, दिस वॉज जस्ट यू नो अ मीम विच आई सॉ ऑन फेसबुक दैट व्हेन यू टेक अ बाथ इन मनी दिस इज लिटरली व्हाट माई सेंस ऑफ ह्यूमर इज नाउ. तो दिस इज हाउ वी प्रेडिक्ट अवर सेल्फ्स कि हमको इतना कुछ आता है एंड देन वी गो इन द मार्केट टू गेट अ जॉब. और हमें जब जॉब मिलती है देन पता चलता है कि इसमें से हम लोगों ने कितना हासिल किया, राइट? सो लेट मी बी वेरी प्रिसाइज एंड फ्रेंक विथ माई होल प्रेजेंटेशन. थैंक यू सो मच वंस अगेन फॉर प्रोवाइडिंग मी दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी. सेटिंग गोल्स इज द फर्स्ट स्टेप एंड टर्निंग द इनविजिबल इनटू विजिबल इज द अनदर वन, राइट? सो what is the meaning of invisible to visible? Something you are just visualizing and something which is already visualized, but this is a stage. If you have earned your BTech degree, BCom kiya hai aapne ya fir BBA kiya hai, BSc kiya hai, kuch bhi kiya hai, abhi uske baad if you want to become something ya fir if you want to pursue your career in the technology, cloud computing is must. Just go and pursue one certification in cloud computing. The first stage of AWS cloud is a solution architect. Go and pursue that thing. You will come to know how much application of cloud is there in various sectors. Agar aapne BCom kiya hai and if you are pursuing cloud computing, believe me guys, you would be earning more than 50,000 a month. Let me be very practical. I am not khwab dikhane nahi aaya yahan pe ki you will earn 10 crores of money or 50 crores of money. Let me be very practical. In India, you will earn at least 50,000. And if you develop and if you pursue further more courses, you will earn a lot in this upcoming phase. So thank you so much once again. And you can contact, we have our own incubation center as ma'am described. If you want, if you have your own startup and if you want mentoring facilities, if you want co-working space, if you want funding opportunities, do contact us on the contact details provided on the last slide. But we have our own incubation center. Whatever idea you have, just speak it to us. We will help you out with all these stages. Thank you so much. Have a good day ahead. Over to chat box and over to, you can ask the questions orally as well. And let us keep this more interactive so that I have completed my, you know, presentation in just 1 hour. So okay, we'll interact with the students that what their future goals are and how they want to pursue their career in cloud.
Okay, the first question is, you might have answered it, still it is a question, so I'm bringing it as a question. That how much does IoT will cost with all resources, or which are the expenses? This is a question from the participants.
Okay, so if I talk about IoT, so it is not certain before, if you can introduce your project, then it depends that what sort of application you want to develop or what sort of cloud you want to acquire to have your own IoT device. So it totally depends on what sort of application you want to build and who is your client and what is the necessity. So you cannot tell in one word or else in few numbers, but it all depends upon what sort of projects you have. If you can share the project, I will be definitely helping you out to guide in this thing.
Sir, please explain the security of our data in IoT.
Oh, wow. So I was expecting this question. So everyone, these days is thinking about a security, right? So if you are connecting your device to any of the clouds, so security is a major concern. You have your own data, you have your personal notes, you have your photographs inside your cell phone. And if you connect IoT to your home or else to your office, so security is the most important thing. So if I tell you very frankly, security ke liye, there are some licenses which needs to be purchased before you install the device at a client's place. So before you enter into this field of IoT, you have to have certifications in ITIL, that is IT infrastructure laws and services. And then you have to pursue a certificate course in a licensed cloud computing engineer. So then you would be bonding the signature with the IT companies that you will not share the data to anyone else. But yes, 99% there is a security, but 1% there is a scope of leaking your data or else leaking your personal information. So you should always take care that where you are applying the IoT and what is the necessity behind that. So keeping these two things in mind, you can consider the security point of view.
What is required qualification for career in cloud computing and IoT?
So as I told you in the presentation as well, so you can pursue your careers in cloud computing at any stage. If you are in, at least if you are in the first year of BTech or else first year of graduation, you can also pursue your career in cloud computing. It is not like that. But certificates will not help you out getting a job or starting your own startups, right? So if I tell you very frankly, if you want to pursue your career in cloud computing, at least you should have a bachelor degree in the field of either IT, either computer science, computer engineering, mathematics, statistics, or physics, so that you would be able to, you know, analyze and integrate your education through the application of this new technology. So I'll better prefer if you go to these fields after your graduation.
Okay. Can you please throw some light on IFTTT, an application of IoT?
It totally depends upon where you use this technology. So basically, it is it helps you to integrate your devices with the cloud computing servers as well as the end service softwares. Like end service software means if you are getting end services from AWS or else if you are getting it from Google Cloud, then you should have, you can integrate these two things and you can, you know, then examine this word, what you call it. So I am very much new to this technology, what you said currently, but yes, this helps you to integrate between the end service providers and to your cloud.
What is the difference between IoT and WSN?
Okay, so basically, the basic difference, if I say about IoT, is something in which you connect your physical devices through a module, or else if you can say through the internet, you should have a module, you should have your device and you should have an internet. But if you connect it remotely or else if you connect it, it from your office, you should have this device through which you can integrate both of these.
If we have to create an app like Gaana or any music app, we have to purchase or create our own cloud to store songs there. Sir, please, I mean, that's what the question is.
It is not necessary that you purchase or you build up your own cloud. You can take services from AWS, you can take services from Google Cloud, or else the best way is you just create a file transfer protocol, that is, we called it as FTP server, and you just upload it on, Google Cloud. So this will help you out creating your own application like Gaana or maybe JioSaavn. So this is something, any of the storage area network, if you take, you know, for example, if any of the private IT companies provide you storage area network space, you can integrate your application through that area space and you can run your own application like JioSaavn or Gaana. It's not required. You should have your own cloud or you have to develop your own cloud.
Electrical engineering students have career in cloud computing? Can diploma in?
Of course, yes. Yes, ma'am, please. Sir.
After that, do they get job? What are the future scope?
So electrical engineers, if I speak, so electrical engineer should pursue the career in cloud computing. Parallelly, they should also have some knowledge of any of, this coding language applications, such as Java or else, for example, Puppet, or something which helps you to develop your own cloud. So electrical engineers can definitely pursue this field. They can do the certification courses. And the second question, what you talked about job. So it all depends upon you. No one guarantees you a job in this field. But yes, if you have developed certain skills to be a solution architect or else to be a cloud DevOps engineer or something, a job role related to cloud, you will definitely get a job in a very good company at a very good pay scale. This is what I can assure. But you should have the skills of coding, the skills of deploying, the skills of cloud computing, and the skills of communication. So communication skills are the most important thing getting job in any of the field. This is what is required.
Okay.
Or else playing any of the video games, right? So what happens is whenever you play that video game, that is basically a cloud only. So what happens is your application is indirectly connected to a Google Cloud through which you get services from the end developers. So what happens is if you want to pursue your career in gaming, and gaming and cloud are two different things. Cloud is a technology through which you give the gaming services to a client. And if you want to really pursue your career in gaming, you have to attend tomorrow's session. He's the best guide to guide you in these things.
If we train any machine learning model, so how cloud services will be helpful to deploy that?
So if you train a machine model, so let me give you a very simple example of chatbot, right? So everyone must be aware about the chatbot which we are using on a website to answer the question of the customers. So what happens is if you have trained a model in such a way that if, for example, if a customer comes and asks on your website, which is the best medicine for diabetes, right? And the answer which it fetches from a limited number of database, so वो जो database है उसके अंदर से it will pick up the best medicine and it will prescribe to a client. So chatbot is something which gives the answer on their own. This is how you have trained the model. और वहाँ पे क्लाउड कंप्यूटिंग का अगर आप यूज देखो तो वो जो आप जहाँ पे भी एप्लीकेशन जो आप रन करते हो या फिर जो भी आप होस्टिंग सर्विसेज आप परचेस करते हो वो डायरेक्टली होता है क्लाउड पे. फॉर एग्जाम्पल ये गो डैडी है या फिर होस्ट इंजर है जहाँ से आप अपना सर्विस स्पेस परचेस करते हो या फिर जहाँ पे आप अपनी वेबसाइट होस्ट करवाते हो या फिर आपने मशीन को ट्रेन कर दिया, एक मॉड्यूल बना दिया, उसको कहीं डिप्लॉय करना पड़ेगा. सो वो डिप्लॉय करोगे आप क्लाउड पे. सो दैट इज वेयर द क्लाउड इज यूजफुल.
Can IoT help in reducing carbon emission and how?
IoT, if you think about its application in automobile sector, then I don't think it can help in reducing the carbon emission because it totally depends upon what sort of application have you developed and you are integrating it in your car. अभी ऐसा तो नहीं है कि आपकी गाड़ी अकेली जा रही है रास्ते पे और वहाँ पे बंद हो गई और गाड़ी चालू रह गई, आपने रिमोटली बंद किया, ठीक है? सो इफ यू थिंक अबाउट द कार्बन एमिशन इन द ऑटोमोबाइल सेक्टर, देन देर आर वेरी लेस पॉसिबिलिटी दैट यू कैन यूज IoT ओवर देयर. बट IoT इज बेसिकली यूज कि अगर आपकी कार, फॉर एग्जाम्पल, कहीं फॉर एग्जाम्पल अगर आप ट्रैवल करते हो, ठीक है, और लंबा सा सफर में कहीं पे आपने गाड़ी रोक दी और इफ यू डोंट नो यू वेंट टू अ बैंक, आप उतर के बैंक में विड्रॉ करने के लिए गए कैश, दिस इज अ स्टोरी व्हाट आई एम डेवलपिंग. अगर आपने कैश विड्रॉ किया और वहाँ पे बहुत लंबी लाइन है और आपने कार चालू रखी थी ताकि कार के अंदर जो लोग बैठे हैं उनको AC मिले, ठीक है, सो वहाँ पे जाके आप देखते हो बहुत लंबी लाइन है एंड देन इफ यू इमेजिन कि इतनी घंटे कार चालू रहेगी तो इतना पेट्रोल कार्बन एमिशन होगा या फिर इतना यूटिलाइज होगा. सो यू कैन रिमोटली कंट्रोल फ्रॉम देयर एंड यू कैन स्टॉप योर कार. सो दिस इज हाउ द कार्बन एमिशन कैन बी कंट्रोल्ड थ्रू IoT इन द ऑटोमोबाइल सेक्टर. इफ यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द इंडस्ट्री सेक्टर देन अगेन यू हैव टू हैव सर्टेन एप्लीकेशंस कि कहाँ से कार्बन एमिशन प्रोड्यूस हो रहा है और कितने रेट ऑफ अमाउंट पे प्रोड्यूस हो रहा है. And there you can utilize the IoT device and you can control it in your factory or else in the industrial application mode. There certainly it will help you out reducing the carbon emission. But you have to first be clear with what your application is.
How might internet address affect the development and implementation of the IoT?
So the word itself contains the word internet, right? So without internet, you are nothing. If you just not think about IoT, just think about a very simple example in today's era that अगर हमारे पास इंटरनेट नहीं है, हमारी सांसें रुक जाती है, ठीक है, व्हाट्सएप मैसेज नहीं आता, इंस्टाग्राम पे रिप्लाई नहीं आता, वी आर वेरी मच इन क्यूरियोसिटी कि कब इंटरनेट पे लॉग इन हो एंड वी वुड बी एबल टू रीड अ मैसेज. तो जस्ट थिंक अ सिनारियो वो एप्लीकेशंस या फिर डिवाइसेस के साथ हो तो क्या होगा. विदाउट इंटरनेट यू कैन नॉट डू एनीथिंग विथ IoT. सो इंटरनेट इज द हार्ट ऑफ द होल थिंग एंड यू शुड हैव एटलीस्ट अ स्ट्रॉन्ग इंटरनेट कनेक्शन टू बी एबल टू कंट्रोल योर डिवाइसेस थ्रू द IoT मॉड्यूल. सो दिस इज हाउ आई कैन आंसर दिस क्वेश्चन.
Okay, CSPs expose a set of application programming interfaces, APIs, that customers use to manage and interact with cloud services, which is also known as management plane. Does it make them more vulnerable to potential exploitation?
You know, this is a question on which a debate can be done. So it totally depends upon how you take it. If you are taking it in a positive sense, of course, yes. And if you are taking it in a negative sense, you have to think twice that is it vulnerable or not. So we cannot directly answer this question, but we should have a clear aspect of what application you are thinking and how APIs you are using. So that should be very much clear before answering this question. So you can email to your descriptive question on the email address which is provided, and you can say what you want to do exactly, and then I can guide you with that.
Is that what are the possibilities of services like Google Stadia, something like this, they say? Google Stadia in India, which does all the processing in the server and projects it on the user's device.
So there are, you know, different kind of services which are being provided, not only in India, but across the globe. These services are across the globe. If you see the Amazon web services, there is an option of you can configure your own, you know, venture over there, and you can utilize your own private personal spaces, right? So it is, there are many companies like IBM in India, which is providing. DigitalOcean is also over here. And Google, Amazon are the two biggest companies which provide you these services. And there are end list of companies. If you see, there are various companies in China as well, which provide this sort of services. But India, these two companies does, and soon Reliance is going to provide this service.
I am Chinmay. Okay. Sir, my question was that Google Stadia does what? That in the gaming, we know that a lot of processing is needed for 3D graphics and all. So what is that? It does that it processes all the data in its server, and then it transfers the data to the user's screen or the controller.
Okay.
So is it possible in India? Because mainly we need a great internet connection first for that. So in future, is it possible that this application is available in India?
Of course, this is possible. So many companies are working on this to provide the best internet services. If you take a lease line, or if you, you know, directly connect it to a server of, let's say, Amazon, or you can connect it remotely, right? So you can do this thing in India as well. So you can do it now as well. It is not a big issue that you can do afterwards. You can do it now.
Is there any difference between cloud and traditional data centers?
Cloud basically is a application of a data center through which your device is connected. So cloud and data center are two different things. Data center is a physical storage device. For example, I'll explain you in simple terms. Aapke college ke andar ek system hai ya fir ek CPU hai jiske andar aapne 6-7 hard disk fit karke rakhi hai, theek hai? So that is your own data center. Agar aap aise bahut sare systems le lo, and if you develop a whole room of data center, and then if you want to control those data center from your home or from your office or from any part of the world, what you need is cloud. So cloud is an interface between data center and the user application. So this two are different things.
I guess all the questions are answered, sir. No more questions are coming. So,
okay. So
thank you very much, sir. For the wonderful presentation, and you explained in detail how exactly the cloud is, why career in cloud computing. You gave the information on cloud careers, different levels in cloud computing, and you also mentioned to the participants that 7.92% should have cloud computing, and what are the opportunities for the startup, and nice interactive session from the participants. It was very well. You answered it very well. So thank you very much, sir.
Ma'am, now, I wanted to answer the last question I see in the chat box. Is there any difference? Yeah, this the question. Last question you asked. someone wrote a galaxy, ye kisi ka mobile hai, that's what I predict. But if I answer, if you can just permit 1 minute, I'll answer this question in brief, that cloud you can consider is it as a virtual data center, and traditional data centers are something which you are deploying physically, right? So this is where the basic difference lies between the question what you carry and the answer which I give, right? So cloud is basically a virtual data center in which you deploy your applications, and indirectly or directly it goes to a traditional data center only. So cloud is just a medium of interface through which you communicate to a traditional data center, nothing else.